What is going on, everybody? In today's video, we are going to be checking out three different reasons that you should level agility early in your account progression. Now, at the current time, agility is one of the least common 99s in old school RuneScape. Actually, it is the least common, the number one least common today. And the reason I know that is because Theoatrix recently put out a video for data visualization on the least common 99s in old school RuneScape, which is actually a really cool video. If you haven't checked it out, I've left a link in the description below. You can check that out. So thanks, Theoatrix, for putting that out. This is actually what gave me the idea for this particular video. So for me, there are three specific reasons that if I had to do this all over again and I knew what I was getting myself into with a fresh account, I would be doing agility very early on in the account. Not only is it incredibly boring, so I want to get it out of the way, but our first reason that we come to is for the full graceful set. The graceful clothing set is a weight reducing gear set that can be bought from Grace, who is in the Rogue's Den underneath of the pub in Burthorpe. Each one of these will cost you a certain amount of marks of grace, which you can get from doing rooftop agility. Now, graceful is incredibly useful because it has weight reduction. All six pieces of the clothing set reduce the weight of items you're carrying, or if you don't have anything in your inventory, the complete set will give you a weight reduction of minus 25 kilograms. And it also has another passive effect, which is run energy restoration. With the full set equipped, you will get a 30% boost to your restoration rate. Now, as we know, or maybe you don't know, the higher your agility level gets, the faster your run energy restores. So all the way at 99, with the 30% restoration rate, your run energy comes back pretty quickly. Obviously, we don't have to have level 99 to get a decent rate of return on energy, but it certainly helps. So for the graceful set, you're looking at 260 marks of grace to get the whole set. And then additionally, you can recolor it, but I'm not going to cover that in this video because we're here for why should you do agility early, not why should you color your graceful set. Now, the reason I say that this is one of the reasons you should pursue agility early is because having graceful will help you out in terms of things like questing. Through questing, there are some quests where you have to run a lot, and having the most possible run energy is really great. You can save on stamina potions. Yes, you could buy those and just use those outright, but you can save a little bit of money by using the graceful set. Obviously, it's going to reduce your run. Another reason that you might want to have the graceful outfit is when you can't use super energy or stamina potions, such as things like Zaya Runecrafting. If you're at the Zaya Runecrafting altars, Blood or Soul, it's a pretty decent run from where you mine the essence all the way to the altar, so you're obviously going to want to make it there as fast as possible. All in all, the graceful clothing set is such a clutch piece of gear to have in your early leveling because it's going to help you with questing and it's going to help you with skilling. I definitely suggest doing this as soon as possible, especially if you are a new player. And once you get closer to maxing, if you still have agility left like I did, you will absolutely dread it. Honestly, if I could go back, I probably would have done this one almost first. My second reason for knocking agility out earlier in a new account is for run energy restoration. The amount of your run energy that gets restored per minute depends on your agility level. So the higher your agility level, the faster that you are going to get your run energy back. Now there is a formula for that, which is used to calculate that. It is E times A equals A over 6 plus 8 over 60, but we don't need that because the old school RuneScape wiki has a cool little chart that tells us exactly what we're looking for. As for the chart, you can see that the higher the level gets, the faster your run energy is restored. As for seconds per 1% of energy, if you have the full graceful set and at level 102 plus, which obviously would be boosted, you will get 1% of energy every 1.875 seconds. So having a higher agility level is definitely going to benefit you in situations where you might not be able to bring stamina potions or energy potions with you, because you'll be racking that energy back up faster and faster as your levels get up there. Now, when I say you want to knock this out earlier, I'm not really referring to get 1 to 99 as fast as you can when you start a brand new account. Would it be useful? Absolutely. But that's not really what I'm talking about. What I am talking about is my third reason, and that is going to be for agility shortcuts. From level 5 all the way up to level 89, you will have the ability to unlock shortcuts throughout the world of RuneScape, and these shortcuts are a godsend. I honestly wish that way earlier I would have had access to a lot more of these shortcuts for a variety of reasons, but the biggest reason is to get where I'm going faster. And these shortcuts, there's a lot of them that really can be useful once you get into the higher levels, such as around level 60 plus. For example, level 60, you can do the Wilderness from the God Wars dungeon area climb, which is pretty good for escaping away from PKers if you are out there killing some spiritual mages or whatever you may be doing. Level 61 is the Slayer Tower medium spike chain climb, which you can use to get up to the Aberrant Spectres or Gargoyles or anywhere on the third floor very quickly. At level 70, you can access the Taverly dungeon shortcut to the Blue Dragons, which is incredibly useful for mid to mid-level accounts because a lot of mid-level accounts do kill Blue Dragons for their dragon bones and hides to make a little bit of money. Even more useful in the Taverly dungeon is going to be the Spiked Blades jump, which will significantly cut your time when getting to Cerberus. And all the way up at level 89 is the Revenant Cave jump, which can easily help you get away from PKers if you are out there. Now, these are just a few examples of the shortcuts. There are many, many more out there, but all of them have their own use, and I promise you will probably come across it at some point. If you don't have the agility level, you're like, man, I really wish I had that one. Now, something that goes hand in hand with the agility shortcuts is also going to be agility areas. There are certain areas in the game that require some act of crossing, which will allow you to enter that area. One example is level 70 at the Ceridoman area of the God Wars dungeon. You cannot get down there by boosting, you have to have level 70, so if you come to a point in your account where you might be 115 combat or something, but you don't have the agility to do that, well, you're out of luck until you actually go get the level. Now finally, I will say this. It might be a good idea not to absolutely max out your agility first, because there is a way that you can also get passive agility XP, and that is through Barbarian Fishing. While you're doing Barbarian Fishing, you will gain passive agility XP, and you will get a decent amount of experience by getting 99 fishing if you do decide to do that. At level 45 agility, you can catch the Leaping Sturgeon, accompanied with level 70 fishing. Now, actually, Barbarian Fishing does offer the most efficient fishing experience from level 58 and higher when you use the tick manipulation method, but we're not really worried about that for this video. What we are worried about is the passive agility XP. You can actually get around 1.2 million experience in both agility and strength by fishing from level 58 all the way to 99 with Barbarian Fishing. So basically, you don't want to max out your agility in the way of efficiency, because you're going to miss out on that 1.2 million passive experience if you do Barbarian Fishing all the way to level 99, so you don't really want to get that post 99 XP and waste all that time. It can save you 1.2 million XP of time at an agility course, which, quite frankly, can be quite a headache because it is, once again, the most unpopular 99 currently in RuneScape. So everybody, I hope that this video has been informative for you, and I hope that can motivate some new players to maybe go after the agility skill early on in the account because of how much more efficient it will make them with questing and other things around the game while they progress their account. If you like this video, or if you learned something new while watching it, leave a like down below. If you have any questions or comments, you can also leave those below, and I will try to get to everything that I possibly can. If you haven't done so yet, tap that subscribe button on your way out. And if you're interested in supporting the channel, you can become a channel member. It helps me keep the channel going and bring new content to you guys. It also shows that you guys really like my videos. So with that, I will see you on the next one. Take it easy, everybody.